I'm going to preface this video just by saying that I have a new audio system and I'm trying to see how it's going to sound with these new videos. So if it's not the best that it could be, I'm sorry about that. I hope it sounds better than some of the other videos I've made where I directly export it from Mixer using my Xbox microphone. So hopefully that sounds at least better than that. That's really what I'm aiming for. And hopefully I can perfect it in the future so it can be as best as it possibly can. And with all that out of the way, what is going on, guys? This is Only One Antidote here. Today I have a Q&A video for you guys. Only people that I personally know are asking questions for me. It's not like I have a huge fan base that I can ask on Twitter for a Q&A. So that's all right. At least people are still finding out more about me, and whoever stumbles across this video can learn more about me too. And even some past subscribers that I don't really have any means of contacting can watch this video and learn more about me. Only One Antidote. First, we have Lindsay, who gave me a slew of questions for me to answer, so I appreciate that very much. The first of which being, what is my favorite gift I have ever received? And I could take that the real common way and saying waking up every morning, but it really is a hard one to answer though. You know, throughout the years, I've gotten this really nice Movado watch, and I have this gaming chair, and I have this little 61 key keyboard that I've been playing for almost 10 years now. It was also really fun whenever I got a new video game console, whether that was the Wii or the Wii U, the Xbox 360, the Xbox One. That always just sent me over the moon. I was always ecstatic to be able to have a new console to play with my friends. In short, I really just can't pick one. There are so many that I have loved receiving. And growing up, it's really, really satisfying to be able to give gifts as well, whether it's to your friends, significant others, parents. I find that feeling really warm as well. Lindsay's next question is, where is my favorite place? Now, like the last one, this one can go many ways as well, but I have visited New York City twice now, and I thought that was really, really fun. I like the city, but I also like the country. I like the beaches. I like the mountains. You know, I like a lot. But New York City is really on the top of that list. Her third question is, what is my favorite sport? Now, if it comes to watching, it's football all the way. If it comes to participating, it's track and field, obviously. And I don't really know where to throw professional wrestling into that. You know, some argue that's not even a sport, but we'll leave it at that for now. Basketball comes second to football, and then third is probably a tie between baseball and ice hockey. Lindsay's final question is, what is an embarrassing moment that I've gone through? And there are so many. If you know me and you know my life, there have been many, and some are not even appropriate to talk about on this channel. But one that I can think of is when I was running the 55-meter dash my junior year, and I was kind of head bobbing a little bit too much. I was leaning forward, and you could slowly see me lose my balance and fall to the ground just maybe 5 meters before the finish line. I ended up getting up and running over the finish line, probably got a time of 12.3 seconds or something like that. Still somehow beat three other people. Don't know how that happened, but yeah, I'd say it's that. My ribs were scraped up the most. My hands were, my wrists were. I was out for the rest of the meet and probably took about 2 weeks or so to get the wrapping off of my torso, but it wasn't too bad. It was just a lot of scraping on the rubber. There's actual footage of that on my channel. If you go back, it's about 2 years ago now. It was in January 2019. Just go back in my videos and you can see it's one of those track meets. It was probably a really short one as well. So if you want to see me fall, you can. These next questions are from my main man, Diaz. He's been one of my best friends for over 10 years now, lives right down the road from me. And he asks, is Diaz really the coolest dude you know? To which I can answer, yes. His follow-up question is, how is there a rock in the stinking grass? And this is a reference to a video from 2012, not even on my channel, on my father's channel. And yeah, just go watch for yourself. Next up is Quinn, who asks, what is my favorite vinyl that I own? When it comes to packaging, hands down, Good Faith by Madion. There is a holographic sleeve. It is so colorful. It's different than the actual cover art that you would see on iTunes or the CD release. It just looks so nice, and that unboxing video is on my channel for you to see. If we're judging what the actual record looks like, Wide-Eyed by Said the Sky, his version 2 album, that looks so beautiful with the lime green and then the pink speckles look so nice. And then a close second to that would probably be Brighter Days by Sigala. Those are both very beautiful discs. While we're on the topic, a vinyl that I wish I owned is Wild Youth by Davin. My God, look at those colors. It's amazing. I believe there was a point in time where I even saw it on the site and it was still available to buy, but I still didn't do it. I may be wrong on that one because this was around December 2019, January 2020. And I don't know if it was still available or not, but I just wish I had it. And he said he's never going to restock it, but there may be a chance of a second version coming out in the future with his acoustic EP along with that. So we'll just see how that one looks, but I don't think anything's going to beat that first one that he released. Quinn finishes with, where's your dream place to live? Japan. Final answer. Our next question is from Izzy, who asks, did you have fun in our video production class? Izzy and I go to college together. We met in a couple of our classes since we're both majoring in video production. The class was pretty fun. It was an intro class, so it was low-key. The projects weren't too hard, and it was fun to do. And I'm really looking forward to the spring semester when we come back on Monday, and it'll be a little more of a challenge. So, yeah, overall, it was a fun time. Some of those projects are actually posted on this channel. You don't have to go too far back, but they should be there. And I hope you enjoy watching them, even though they're really just mediocre. Moving on to Riley, who is another friend I met at college, who asks, are you excited for your second semester at college? I am for the most part. I think it should be a good time. My advisor wanted me to take a bunch of gen ed, so I'm going to be doing that. And two of them actually ended up being online courses. So I'm not going to go to the campus as much as I thought. My fall semester, I had every class in person, which I was really grateful for. But this time around, it's not that. So we'll see how it goes. As I said before, I'm going to be in video production one, and hopefully that isn't too bad. He also asks if I have a dream camera, which right now I do not. I haven't really been looking around. But in the future, I'd like to upgrade from what I currently have, which is a Canon Vixia. So hopefully that happens, because it's just a small camcorder that does the job. But I'd like to have something a little bigger and better. He has a larger following than I do, but I'm going to give a shout out to his channel. It's Ghostly Vlogs. So go check that out. That's Riley's channel. He does a really good job. Izzy's also featured in one of those videos, so that's lit. Next up is one of my real best friends, Andrew, who asked, when is it at the point in time you believe the world was truly at its worst? This is probably the deepest question that I've gotten, and it really just depends on what magnitude you're looking at. Like right now, what we're doing right now through the pandemic is one of the worst. Definitely the worst in our time. There's also just a lot of civil unrest and just a lot of mayhem around the country, and it's really sickening to see. We're at a point in time where long tenured friends are not friends anymore because of different political opinions, and that just used to never be that way. It never used to be Democrats versus Republicans. They just had different views, and they accepted those views no matter what happened. But to directly answer the question, I'd say when the world was at its worst is during any pandemic, whether it's this current one, the one from 100 years ago, the plague, you know, anything like that. And also both the world wars, obviously. As for the United States, I believe we were at our worst during the Great Depression, Pearl Harbor, and 9/11. Andrew's final question is if Skyzo is releasing new music, and that's his alias for his music production. And to answer that, I believe the answer is yes. I don't know when, but I will obviously advertise that when it comes, and I'm happy to see what the outcome is. Another one of my best friends, Ian, is asking me how college is going, and the first semester was great. I made Dean's List. The gen eds were a little boring, but, you know, it was just how it is. Even my advisor put it this way, that they're important and necessary, even if they are boring. And the actual classes that were based off my major, I had a pretty good time in, so it was decent for the most part, and it might be a little hard to go back since I've been off for well over a month now, but I think once I get into it, it'll be a good time. The gen eds I took last semester were speech and college writing, and those turned out all right. They weren't horrible, but, you know, like I said before, they weren't really too exciting either. And the gen eds that I'm taking this semester are statistics, American national government, and general psychology, with psychology and national government being the two classes that have switched to an online format. I think it'll be slightly easier to handle this year because I've never taken statistics before, and I've also never taken psychology before, so I think I'll gain a general interest in that, hopefully. And the final question is from my beautiful girlfriend, Riley, and she asks, how many mice does it take to screw in a light bulb? I'm sure there is a legitimate answer to this question, but I don't know it because I'm very uncultured, so I'm sorry, babe. And that'll do it for this Q&A video. I thank everybody who participated in this and made this video possible. You really mean the world to me. Again, I apologize if the microphone quality is mediocre. I am still working out the kinks, still trying to find what fits best for it, and hopefully it wasn't too horrible to listen to. With that, I thank you all for watching. Please leave a like if you enjoyed, and a comment down below if you have any more questions about me. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.